Sunday. I'm like, yo, what do you guys have to say? Yeah, sure. Fine
No,
again.
honestly, like this might seem dumb or obvious, but this is something like we all kind of ignore in our daily lives, right? Like we'll always think about, huh, we need to set goals, but upon it, and
Yes.
that's why it is very important. Like it is important to write these things down, like have this set in your head. Key, I want to do this. I want to do this today. And if I have like an overarching like end goal that I want to reach, like how do I reach that? These are the steps of what I want to do, and this is how I will reach it. Because until and unless you start your work and you start your journey towards it, there's no way you'll reach that destination, right? You need to start somewhere. You need to take that first step to reach that end goal. So basically, that's
Yeah.
what like you need to realize in your life every day.
Correct. I mean, the only thing I can add to this is like the only tip I can give you, which sort of I've used and works for me, is to rely on pen and paper. And I buy like a lot of pocket diaries, right? Like stuff that just is very small, can fit into my pocket, and I don't need to have a bag or something. And I've sort of scattered a lot of these pocket diaries around my house, and I have a lot of them in my bag. I have to the college where I go to, and the idea is whenever I want to like really have a to-do list, I will make sure that I scribble it down, pen and paper, and I sort of try to live up to that to-do list. And once you really write it down, and if you don't do it at the end of the day, you actually feel a little bad, because till you don't write it down, nah, it's only mental. So you haven't manifested it, you haven't made it real, because it's still in your thought. I mean, raise your hands if you've been somebody who's procrastinated something so simple for like a bunch of years. Like I'm raising my hand. I know you can't. Something as simple as
हम
like,
देख नहीं सकते, we can't see you guys,
yeah,
but हाँ
but my hand is
I'm
raised.
also raising.
Sometime in the future, podcast will have a look
We'll have a poll, like how many of you raised your
at
hands?
yeah. The idea is you want to first of all make that journey from thought to reality, and really write down the thing that you want to do, and then that sort of brings you to the next juncture where sort of you have only two ways you can go about this. One is things or goals you want to achieve that you enjoy. Stuff like, I want to play the guitar. I want to be a
It's
better
what you want to do
lead
as your
model.
hobbies, right? Like that's what
Yeah,
I
so
mean, I'm
there
guessing.
are two things. One is stuff that you have control over and stuff you enjoy. The second one, unfortunately, is something that you don't have control over. Things like, okay, I just joined a new job, and everybody seems to be better than me. I got to get better at it. What do I do? Let's say I want to be better at Google AdWords, or I want to be better at search engine optimization, or I want to be better at coding, or a whole bunch of other things. That might not be in your hand.
That's not the easiest thing to achieve,
Yeah.
like being good at those particular things, but it is something you need to put effort in, right? At the end of the day,
Correct.
even if it's things you enjoy, like until and unless you start putting in that effort, you won't be able to reach that goal. And that's why setting and having that goal and pushing yourself to achieve that goal is very important, because
Correct.
until and unless you have something in your head that's very tangible and that's very like developed in as a thought in your head, and you want to do it, until you have that, you won't like start anything. Like you need to and it might seem scary. It really does seem scary to, especially like when it comes to bigger goals, set those things up, whether it be like getting or starting up your own company, or making your company reach some like high level, or be one of the top 100 people
Yeah.
who have startups. Yes, it seems like a very scary goal. It seems like a very difficult thing to achieve, but then you won't be able to go there until and
It's
unless you
scarier
have it in
when
your,
you start. Like, to be very honest, like, it's really scary when you haven't started. And it's weird, but it starts becoming a little less and scary the more you put your time at it. And the idea is to begin as early as you can.
And the funny thing about all of this is, like, you kind of start feeling happy about achieving those smaller milestones. It's a weird thing that when you're not doing it, but you have it in your head that I want to go there, you'll always feel that scared and weirdly lonely feeling of like, how do I do this? Like, am I not good? Will I be able to achieve that? Will I be good enough? Yes, that does seem scary. But if you don't do anything, it gets worse. You kind of get inside your own head at times. You'll be mulling it over and sometimes putting yourself down. But the day you start achieving those smaller milestones towards that end goal, that's when you start realizing, okay, I'm making the movement. I'm making like those, I'm taking those small steps that'll help me reach there. And it just starts making you feel better. And the better, and the more like you feel like you've been productive and you've been doing something worthwhile, the more more effort you start putting in at the end of the day. And it's like a cycle, right? Like you can kind of call it a cycle of like just, in a way, mental health wise also, it'll help you just improve. And finally, like, even though that end goal is not easy to achieve, you'll have more confidence in yourself. You'll find yourself feeling like you're doing something bigger and you are becoming something better than what you were previously. And that's just a massive, massive difference to you, yourself, and your self-confidence, self-worth, self-importance. It's very important. Important because at the end of the day, self-love is what comes first. And if you don't feel comfortable with yourself or happy with yourself, it can really affect you in a very bad way in the long term.